I was in Islamabad. I got a call from a television journalist from London. And he asked me a question. He said, Imran Khan, aren't you ashamed of the terrorist attack in New York? I am sitting in Pakistan. Attack takes place in New York. There's no Pakistani involved. And this man is asking me to be ashamed of something because I'm part of 1.3 billion people. Political struggle was being given a religious name. How could an event like 9/11 take place? And there was never any inquiry into the root causes. Why did those people blow themselves up? If anyone tried to ask the question, they were accused of appeasing terrorism. They were accused of justifying terrorism. George Bush went on television and told the world that this is radical Islam. They want to take over the world. They hate our way of life. They hate our freedom. They hate our democracy. They are like Nazism. This is a new philosophy like communism. Stakeholders who had an interest in the oil in Iraq, the neoconservatives, all of them then projected this mad philosophy of radical Islam. First, Afghanistan was attacked 3 weeks after an event. War was made the first option, not the last resort. Some 50,000 people were killed when not one Afghani was involved in 9/11. Soon Iraq followed. After lies and deception, saying that Saddam was connected with Al-Qaeda, putting the fear of God in their own population so that they would not question them. Other stakeholders jumped in. Ariel Sharon, suddenly he was fighting against Islamic terrorists. In Chechnya, Vladimir Putin was fighting against Islamic terrorists. In Kashmir, again there were Islamic terrorists who were fighting the Indian troops. No one bothered to say that before 9/11, 70% of all suicide bombers were Tamil Tigers who were Hindus.